Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Nandita Shah from University of Asia Pacific, and I'm here to present my presentation on Chapter 4 of Satrip's WIP Manual regarding the tensile and shear capacity of post-installed bonded anchors in low-strength concrete with brick chips in it. This is the outline of my today's presentation. Chapter 4 basically includes four sections, of which I'm going to describe the general background at first. Due to the geological position as shown in this photo, Bangladesh has a great potentiality to have earthquakes anytime. Even though there is no record of big earthquakes in Bangladesh, it was affected by the recent earthquake at the neighboring country, Nepal. This photo shows the tilting of a building in Dhaka due to the Nepal earthquake. The existing reinforced concrete buildings in Bangladesh are structurally of poor strength. There are records of RC building collapse in Bangladesh without any major earthquakes. For example, this picture shows the photo of Rana Plaza collapse from the year 2013, which occurred without any earthquake. A vital reason of why those buildings are not of that much strong is that most of the existing RC buildings in Bangladesh are constructed using concrete with brick chips as core aggregate. For this seismic potentiality and existing unsafe RC buildings in Bangladesh, the government of Bangladesh is planning of retrofitting those buildings. Among the available retrofitting techniques, post-installed bonded anchors is one of the key elements to retrofit existing buildings. It connects the existing RC buildings with the newly installed strengthening members in order to transmit the load smoothly. This photo shows the application of the use of the post-installed bonded anchor in retrofitting of an existing beam column joint with wing wall. These blue colored members are the post-installed bonded anchor. The design and application process of post-installed bonded anchors are so simpler than the most other available retrofitting techniques, resulting in its increased popularity in building strengthening. The tensile capacity and the shear capacity of post-installed bonded anchor shall be basically evaluated according to the CNCRP BSPP manual for the seismic retrofit. However, the difficult part is that there is not sufficient data to cover the cases associated with the low-strength concrete, and this is a barrier to retrofit existing buildings with low-strength concrete. In order to overcome this problem and to set out a reliable manual, experimental studies were conducted by Osaka University in cooperation with BUEC to investigate the behavior of post-installed bonded anchors in low-strength concrete with brick chips. A series of scaled pullout tests and a series of full-scale pullout tests was performed to evaluate the tensile capacity. And one series of full-scale shear tests was conducted to evaluate the shear capacity of the post-installed bonded anchors in concrete with brick chips and having low strength. The result from the test concluded that the Japanese guideline evaluated the tensile and shear capacity of the post-installed bonded anchor in low-strength concrete conservatively, implying application of CNCRP BSPP manual to be safe to use to design the post-installed bonded anchor. The section 4.2 of chapter 4 shows the scope of this manual. The followings are the main scopes of this guideline. It will enhance the scope of the CNCRP BSPP manual by covering the compressive strength of concrete ranging from 10 MPa to 36 MPa. And it will cover the lowest in concrete ranging from, which is defined as 10 to 15 MPa concrete in this chapter. Chemically bonded single anchored are covered by this manual. And it will also cover the pullout test and the shear test of post-installed bonded anchor in lowest in pure concrete or reinforced concrete. Section 4.3 of the chapter 4 shows the design guidelines, specimen preparation, loading, and test setup of the post-installed single bonded anchor in low-strength concrete to determine the tensile capacity as well as the shear capacity. First, I will discuss about the design of tensile capacity. According to the present CNCRP, BSPP manual are basically prepared based on the Japanese seismic evaluation standard of existing reinforced concrete buildings, which is JBDPA 2001. According to this guideline, the tensile capacity of single anchor, TA, should be the minimum of the smallest of the TA1, which is determined by steel strength, TA2, which is determined by concrete cone strength, and TA3, which is determined by bond failure strength. Now, I'm going to show a sample of example of designing post-installed bonded anchor in RC slab with low strength concrete. This one is basically from the scale test performed in Japan. A half-scaled RC slab of 75 millimeter thickness was used for this test. The slab was made with only 11.7 MPa concrete. The anchors were placed in the center of the area between the slab reinforcement as shown in this picture. The parameters for the selection of the specimen were the anchor diameter with bearing embedment length. After making holes in the specimen and filling it with epoxy and inserting the anchor, it was kept untouched for 24 hours using this type of temporary support, wooden supports. This is the test setup and the loading system we used for the test. A center hole, a hydraulic ram was used to give the load, and the load was given in this direction. The compressive strength was 11.7 and the elastic modulus of concrete was also low. Two types of failure of concrete failure and steel fracture was observed from the test. And from this graph where we can see the straight line representing the calculated strength by the Japanese guideline, and the red circle shows the experimental result. And from the graph, we can see that the concrete cone failure occurred at a higher strength than the predicted one by the Japanese guideline. This happened because the calculated failure area was smaller than the actual experimental failure area, representing that the Japanese guideline evaluated the tensile capacity of the post-install bonded anchor in low strength concrete conservatively. And that is why we can use the CNCRP BSPP manual for this type of designing as well. For case of steel failure, the specimen which failed in steel fracture also reached its ultimate strength beyond to its tension at yielding. And it also represents that Japanese guideline also evaluated the steel failure strength of post-install bonded anchor conservatively. And if we check the, another important part was found that if we keep the embedment length, effective embedment length greater than or equal 10 times the diameter of the anchor, we can avoid the brittle type of failure. For the full scale test, we also selected like 7 types of specimen, among which P1, P4, 5, 6, and 7 were of low strength concrete with bearing diameter and bearing effective embedment length. We used pure concrete block for this test with no reinforcement in it. And we used feta sand in order to produce the low strength concrete representing the available or used concrete of Bangladeshi buildings. And the concrete strength varied from 10.1 to 14.65 MPa. The anchor properties are shown in this graph. Rebar of diameter 10, 16, and 20 millimeter were used for this test. The loading setup was exactly similar with the scale test performed in Japan. And from the result, we could find that the expected failure modes perfectly matched with the experimental failure mode. And bond failure of adhesive concrete interface and bond failure of steel adhesive interface was found. And we also confirmed that if we keep the effective embedment length equal or greater than 10 times the anchor diameter, we can avoid the brittle failure. The strength of the anchor were also found to be greater than the expected or calculated strength by the Japanese guideline. This also represents that the Japanese guideline evaluated the strength conservatively. Now, some of you might think, like, why we are focusing on Japanese standard, why we are not using the American standard or ACI code? Well, the tensile capacity of single anchor, according to the ACI code, should be the smallest of NSA, which is determined by steel failure, NCB, which is determined by concrete cone failure, and NA, which is determined by bond failure. And then we placed the predicted value of the strength of the post-install bonded anchor predicted by ACI code and Japanese code, and we plotted it against with the experimental data. And for a scale test, and even for the full scale test, we found that ACI could predict it more conservatively than the Japanese standard. Now, talking about the shear capacity, the Japanese guideline says that according to Japanese guideline, the shear capacity of the single anchor should be the minimum of QA1, which is determined by steel strength, and QA2, which is determined by bearing strength of the concrete. And For the full skill test, we selected two types of specimen for the test with concrete strength 10 MPa. And this is the setup we followed, which we collected from the ASTM E488. And this was our like target anchor for shear test. And from the experimental result, we found that the Japanese guideline predicted the shear capacity of the post-tensile bonded anchor in low strength concrete conservatively. And the expected failure mode was matched with the experimental failure mode. This shows the shear test photo. And we can see that here the concrete bearing failure occurred. Now, section 4.4 includes some limitations. Anchor diameter, which are greater than 20 millimeter, and concrete greater than 36 MPa are not covered by this guideline. Lightweight concrete is also out of the scope of this guideline. And in conclusion, we found that the current CNCRP BSPP manual can be used for designing the tensile capacity of post-install bonded anchor in low strength concrete, and it is adequate as well as safe. And the Japanese standard can be used to design the shear capacity of post-install bonded anchor in low strength concrete. And another recommendation we found from our experimental data is that if we keep the embedment length equal or greater than 10 times the anchor diameter, it will be safer. And this recommendation can be applied for the retrofitting design. Thank you, everyone.